Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
Well, if you're watching the story on Santa Cruz, you saw it was an absolutely perfect day for the paddle out. It was gorgeous all along our coast. A little subtropical moisture came up there. Clouds up above 12,000 feet drifting over our sky. Made for a nice sunset tonight, but the low stuff still staying just around about San Luis Obispo and slowly trying to sneak its way up. We'll see what happens with that here in a minute. 80 degrees in Ben Lomond, couple warmer in Boulder Creek, Scotts Valley, another 80 for Santa Cruz and 84 in Watsonville today. So as promised, a warm day. But I also promise you'll be a little cooler than yesterday, and worked out about right. Mid-70s to about 80 degrees, Monterey along the peninsula, 78 Carmel by the sea, and PG, pretty nice stuff. You don't see that in July and August. 86 in Carmel Valley and almost 90 in Big Sur, matching up with Gonzales today. 93 Soledad, 96 your hot spot today in King City, 10 degrees cooler in Salinas, and an 86 also for San Jose, with 87 pretty much doing the rest of the Santa Clara Valley there between Morgan Hill and Hollister. And 88 did it for Bakersfield, Fresno, 86 in Redding, so our temperatures almost identical to what was going on in the Central Valley. Only a few times of the year you get to see that. 82 in San Francisco, 1 degree warmer than LA, and it's much cooler down there now because of the fog than it is up here. Still have an offshore flow here. 97 in Palm Springs, so nobody too hot. 58 in Seattle, Mile High City, and at 72, matching up with St. Louis and New York, 77 in Atlanta, GA, 83 in New Orleans, so still a little warmth along the southern tier. The really cold air is still locked up here in the Canadian prairies. Once that comes down, we start getting those collision boundaries for thunderstorms in the late season. Right now, showers and thunderstorms, but no severe weather, a lot of rain on the east coast there, and of course, they had it last night from the nation's capital. That has since cleared out, but it's still lingering around the Great Lakes. And over the weekend, it'll take its time moving out there, low pressure trough. High pressure ridge over most of the two-thirds of the country, so not a lot of wet stuff going on. A couple of showers tracking up through Idaho and Montana in the high country, but that's about it. Meanwhile, one low is up along the Aleutians. The other low is developing way off to the south. This will become a cutoff low. Kind of tricky to forecast, but likely it may only send us a couple of high clouds along with what's coming up here, and ultimately it moves into the north, but it'll probably fizzle out when it does. Here's the future cast version. Let me step out of the way. You can see it drifting around on the left-hand side of your screen. High pressure ridge comes back in Monday, a little bit warmer then, and then as this low moves through, it cools it off, but by then it's mixed out any kind of a marine layer that develops over the weekend, so we still have nice fall weather to look forward to. Southerly winds in the morning, and that brings in a little bit of fog and low clouds, and then by Sunday, the moisture levels increase, might linger around some parts there for one day, when you know it, on the weekend, but by Monday it's all gone again, and we're looking at pretty nice weather for next week. We'll probably have to wait a week longer before we get into the wet stuff. Meanwhile, 72 looks like a good day to be in the city of San Francisco, some 80s in the South Bay, low to mid 80s ought to do the trick in the Santa Clara Valley, with most lows still in the 50s, so those will be your daytime highs in a couple of months, may as well enjoy it. 74 in Salinas to 86 in King City. So we bump it down a little bit just because we can start to get a little more of that ocean air coming in by afternoon, certainly with a southerly surge. Upper 60s to low 70s. We'll try for one more day around the peninsula with an 82 possible for Carmel Valley. Likewise, Boulder Creek. And mid-70s along the coast from Davenport to Moss Landing. So, yeah, still a great way to get through a weekend. High clouds tonight, a little bit of local bay fog in the wee hours of the morning. Probably only Monterey, if it makes it to Salinas, that'll be it. But by tomorrow night, we get more of that. So you're going to have fog and low clouds in the morning lingering around parts of the bay. Partly cloudy elsewhere, just those high clouds again. And for Sunday, pretty much cloudy around the coast and the north end of the Salinas Valley, I'm thinking. Partly cloudy inland in the afternoon, so we'll get a little bit of a break. But it all mixes out by Sunday night, and that gets temperatures up a little bit again after a couple of days of cooler in the valleys and the mountains, and then drops back to about normal with 70s for the valleys and mostly mid-60s to mid-70s for the coast. Again, we will see some clouds over the weekend, but it doesn't look like anything in the way of rain this far south. Perhaps another week or so will do it. So we got plenty of time for that.
It's really been an amazing
week. Yeah, it's kind of nice. This is really kind of nice. At least we got out of that fog.
It's downright hot. You know?
Yeah, oh yeah. It's the last couple of days. So for some, that's a little too much.
Yeah.
We'll bring it down a notch and make you comfortable. So.
All right.